गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ लेट अस डू द सेकेंड चैप्टर ऑफ द हिस्ट्री. तो इन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर यू हैव लर्नड व्हाट इज हिस्ट्री एंड इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंस. यू ऑल्सो लर्न द रिलेशन बिटवीन हिस्ट्री एंड ज्योग्राफी एंड वी हैव ऑल्सो डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द टाइम फ्रेम एंड द वेरियस सोर्सेज ऑफ हिस्ट्री. सो नाउ इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल नो अबाउट early humans, their stages of evolution, the various ages, that is the stone age or the paleolithic age, mesolithic age, neolithic age and the chalcolithic age, and also about the early discoveries and invention. So what is evolution? So in this chapter we will discuss about the evolution in the first part. So what is evolution? Evolution means a slow development of human beings from apes to modern people, and this is called evolution. So human beings have passed through several stages of evolution before attaining their present form and size. So Charles Darwin, one of the biologists, he gave the theory of natural selection and survival of the fittest. So depending on that, so the earliest human beings were known as hominids. Hominids, who are hominids? They belong to the family of primates, which were ape-like animals. And who are the ape-like animals? They included chimpanzees, gorillas and orangutans. So hominids learned to walk erect over a period of time. And when they learned to walk erect, they were called Homo erectus. Means they were able to stand upright and walk. So the erect posture of these humans enabled them to see in all directions. They had low forehead and protruding face. So these were the features of Homo erectus. And now it helped them to make better use of their hands. Their brains were well developed, and over a period of time these Homo erectus, these men learned to protect themselves and secure their livelihood by coordinating their intellect and physical abilities. So they were hunters and gatherers, and they could make stone implements. They lived in caves or other natural shelters, knew the use of fire, and ate wild fruits and raw flesh of animals. These Homo erectus men, they traveled from Africa to different continents around 5 to 7 to 5 lakh years ago. And with time they developed certain special attributes, and due to the climate and the other environmental conditions of those places. It was around this time when the Stone Age began, about 5 lakh years ago. So depending on the climate, depending on what they were getting to eat and how they had developed their biological features, so culturally also they improved. Okay. Homo erectus men of this period, the Java, Peking men and the Heidelberg men, were most notable. And we can find their remains. When you study history, when you look for their remains, we could find them in Indonesia, China, Germany and some countries of Africa respectively. So these Java men, they belong to Indonesia. And what were their features? They were tall, with a small brain. They could bend forward and were more similar to apes rather than the present day men. They could speak, but now knew how to make stone tools. And then there was another, the Peking men. They lived in the caves of China and could stand more upright than the Java men. This was the phase of evolution, right? And charred bones and remains of those implements found in the caves implied that they knew the use of fire and art of making stone implements. Then came the Heidelberg men. They lived in China. So they were found around 40,000 years ago. These modern men were referred to as Homo sapiens. Homo sapiens means wise men. Why? Because they had the power to think. They used more refined tools for hunting. In fact, they perfected the art of making tools from stones and bones. Then the Neanderthals were a subspecies of Homo sapiens. Several remains of the Neanderthals have been found in different parts of the world. The Neanderthals men knew the use of fire. They also knew how to make better stone implements, make use of animal skin for clothing, and found shelter in caves. The more modern men lived in well-constructed huts and used weapons for hunting and fishing.